Good morning, children. The lesson multiples and the factors is going on, beta. And that day we have learned divisibility test for 2, 5, and 10. So one question is left from exercise problem 633. One question is left. So let us see, beta. It is question number 2. A river is long. I need 8 pieces. I need 8 pieces of river each 40 centimeters long. How many centimeters shorter is the river? Then the length I need. What is question, beta? The length of the river is 3 meter. Okay. And I need to divide this 3 meter into 8 pieces. Now see, children. 3 meter means what? Okay. And the length of each piece is 40 centimeter. 40 centimeter. Okay. So let's start. 3 meter is equal to 300 centimeter. Okay. And to make the piece of 40 centimeter means you have to divide this 300 by 40 centimeter. Okay. But, okay, let's see now. Length of number of pieces divided by 40. Okay, is 0 and cancel. But what is left with a 30 divided by 4? But 30 is not the multiple of 4. What is the next multiple of 4 after 30? 30 divided by 4. 8 fours are 32. But here we have 30. So how much centimeters are left to make 32? 2 centimeters. Therefore, 32 minus 30 equals to 2 centimeters. So, 2 centimeter is left, or 2 centimeter is shorter in length of I need. So, I need So if you divide 30 by 4, you get some fraction. Okay, but to get the whole number, it would be 32. So how much centimeter is shorter? 2 centimeter is shorter. Got it, children? Okay, so let's solve question number 5. One table is given. If the number given in the table is divisible by the given divisors, so if it is divisor, you have to put the red tick mark. If it is not divisible, so you have to put the cross in the box. Got it, beta? Okay, so I'm making only the table. It is question number 5. There is divisor. The numbers are 34. Okay. Now, children, you have to check whether it is divisible by 2, 5, and 10. Okay, the first number is 15. So, recall the 2's divisibility test. The unit place must have 0, 2, 4, 6, or 8. But it has 5. So 15 is not divisible by 2. What is the divisibility test for 5? Unit place should have either 5 or 0. Yes, it has 5. That is what it is divisible by 5. 10. Unit place must have only 0. It has 5. So it is also not divisible by 10. Got it, beta? In this way, you have to solve this. 30. Unit place has 0. Yes. 2 is the divisor of 30. Yes. Unit place has 0. Yes. 5 divisibility test tell us unit should have either 0 or 5. It is 0, that's why it is also divisible by 10. Got it, beta? And now let's see. 34. Unit place has 4. Yes, 2. So here I'm writing for 2. Unit place. We have 0, 2, 4, 6, or 8, 4, 3, sorry, 4, 5. This must have either 0 or 1. And for 10, it took only 0. Okay. So 34, see, the unit list has 4. So it is divisible by 2. It doesn't have any 0 or 5, so it would not be divisible by 5 and also by 10. 46. Yes, we place as 6 is divisible by 46. No 0 of 5 and no 0. So the next number is 55. Unit place as neither 0, 4 or 6, 8. So it is not divisible by 2. Yes, unit place have 5. So it is divisible by 5. It is not 0. So it is not divisible by 10. Got it, beta? Now see the next question. So the unit place doesn't have any 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. It has 3. So it is not divisible by 2. Also, it doesn't have 0 or 5. So, loss. And it is not 0. Next, 63 is not divisible by 2, 5, and 10. 70. Yes, for divisibility test of 2, it has 0. It has 0, that's why it is divisible by 5 and also by 10. 84. Unit place has 4, so it is divisible by only 2. Why? Because 5 and 10 equate 0 or 5. Got it, children? So, you can check whether 2, 5, 10 are the divisor of the given number by applying the divisibility test. Got it, children? Okay. So let's see the another term, prime numbers. Okay, prime number means what is that? A number having only two factors, one and the number itself. Factors means the divisors. So divisor, if the divisor of any number is only one and the number itself, that number is what? Prime number. A number which has only two factors . So how many factors a number has? If it is 2, the number is prime numbers. Composite number is a number having more than 2 factors. Now see the example of this. 5. What are the factors of 5? Or what are the divisors of 5? 1 is common to all. Okay. 1, it comes, this 5 comes in the ones table and also it comes in the itself. 5 itself 7 1 7. Who wants to win? 1 and 2. 3 1 and 3. Then 11 1 and 11. 13 1 and 13. 17 1 and 17. 23 1 and 23. So prime numbers are also infinite. Okay, why? Because natural numbers are infinite. Okay, so these are the some examples of prime numbers. Okay, now let's see composite number. A number having more than two factors. A number has more than two factors. So what are the composite numbers having more than two divisors? Having more than two divisors. For example, 4. What are the divisors of 4? 1, 2, and 4. 6, 1, 2, and 6. 8. 100 1 2 5 10 20 25 50 and 100. Okay, so these are the some examples of composite numbers. So like prime numbers, composite numbers are also infinite. Got it, beta? So these are the examples of composite numbers. So I am giving you one question to solve. Circle the prime numbers in the list given below. So children, these are the two questions you have to solve. Okay, beta. So we are stop over here. Bye bye, children. Bye bye, beta.